time to use all of these Canva skills we've learned in the year.
Learn a valuable skill.
Help the bored kids by creating a game on Canva. When you've landed on your homepage, go select videos, and with the video, open a 920 by 1080 canvas. There are two ways that you can go about creating the game. You can come up with your own game concepts and puzzles, or you could do what I do. I use ChatGPT, the 3.5, the free version. What I did, I went and I asked ChatGPT to give me game ideas. And once it has done that, I asked it to give me each slide that I could create to have my game exciting and go ahead and create all of these slides that ChatGPT gave me ideas on. So it has like 7 slides where I'm going to be asking people to solve these mysteries or solve these quizzes in order for them to move from one room to another and not be trapped in the house. So it's quite exciting. And if you have now opened up your first slide, you need to open and create the landing page of your mystery mansion escape game. We're going to go to our elements and we're going to be looking for a dark background with red. And I set it as a background and I'm happy with it. Then I go back to my elements and I look for a cloud. And we go back to our elements and we look for a haunted, like a haunted house. And then we add text, so we're gonna press T for text. And we will type the name of our game. And the font we're gonna be using is called Freckle Face. And I want it all to be caps. And we're gonna add our shapes and we add a let's play with our shapes. So we're gonna go back to our lines and shapes and we are going to add the shape. We also want it to have that bright yellow color, but we want a border weight around it and we want it to have like a freakishly kind of a border weight. And then we're gonna type let's play on there using the same font. That takes care of page number one. I added a lightning on there so that it creates a nicer effect. And then we're gonna click on add page so that we are on our second page. We then copy the background and we can add it to the second page. Someone duplicate that for the third page to make things easy for ourselves. On our second page, we need to give an instruction of how the game is played. So using the same type of text, we're going to add on there and you give an instruction of how the game is played. Otherwise, it's pointless. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta... Okay, now you've set up your scene, you told them how to play. Now we're moving to room one. According to ChatGPT, pick any of these puzzles and start creating the room. And then give the people an answer in order for them to move on to the next page. I want to start with the enchanted painting room and I want to create this on our mystery room. We're going to go to our magic media and we're going to be creating a painting of Mona Lisa. So let's create a painting of Mona Lisa. It's worth it. This society is really trying me. Ain't no hide and seek, I hide to be far. And generate landscape. Generate an image, see what we get. It works quite perfect with our theme and what we're trying to do here. To add mystery on the painting, we're going to give Mona Lisa a cell phone and then ask the people that are playing what is wrong with the image. That way, if they look at it, they're able to see it or not. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. I just gotta get through, I just gotta get through. Cause I feel like taking off, find a place. What you could do here is to add a timer. So if you go to pixabay.com and you search for timer, there are plenty of timers that are free that you could add, and for as long as you want the people to be in the room and having fun with your game. So I have a timer that I found that I'm going to add on here. If you don't know how to add a timer and you've missed that video, I'll link it in the description just to help you along. So I'm going to add a 10-second timing option for the people who are playing the game to have a look at the image and then solve the mystery. And then on the next slide, I give them the correct answer of what was supposed to be there. And if they got it right, they move on to the next room. Allow me to interrupt a little bit just to let you know that if you're enjoying this video tutorial, we have a Canva course that has 72 lectures on Udemy. And it's currently on special, so go grab it and enjoy Canva. Let's get back. Next, add the flow transition on all pages so that it flows like that on all of the slides. And I want to apply it on all pages. Then it makes the game flow quite nicely. The other thing, I'm going to be adding music on here. I do have videos on how to add music on Canva. You can also go grab them from the playlist. I will link them in the description as well. Below. It's as easy as that. I'm not going to be creating a video where I'm creating 7 rooms, because then the video will probably be like 2 hours long. I wanted to show you to have fun during this holiday. Apply all that you've learned this year with Canva and all of these other websites. I'm going to be fast forwarding this. The game is going to be available on my store if you want to download it and use it. You can go grab it there. But lastly, let's have a look at the full game. Life is a nuisance, tie up some loose ends. I try to be human, find a solution, my evolution. A place like this, it didn't exist, we made it like this. So you can go pick the bad or the good, got a glass half wish. I know, it's easier to hide than just to lay low. Not everyone in life has got a halo. I'm standing in the red inside a payphone, just wanna break.